term V2X is used to describe communication between, to, and from vehicles, with a V2X standing for vehicle to everything, or specifically, vehicle to vehicle, vehicle to infrastructure, vehicle to pedestrian, and vehicle to network. So, let's take this opportunity to explain what we mean by each of these and discuss the types of use cases that call upon this type of communication. Beginning with V2V, or vehicle to vehicle. This type of communication refers to the direct exchange of data between vehicles, one-to-one or one-to-many. As such, a radio connection is established between the vehicles without the need to pass the data via cell towers, a process termed sidelink. Examples of these types of use cases which call upon V2V communications include platooning, in which vehicles will be able to travel in very close proximity, safely and at high speeds. This is often associated with autonomous vehicles, in that they will take control of the driving, but platooning will also call upon very close cooperation and communication between each vehicle in the group. The benefits of joining a platoon include improved aerodynamic performance, increased road capacity, and better fuel efficiency. Other examples include cooperative maneuvering, when vehicles overtake each other or join a busy highway from a slip road, sensor sharing, in which information from cameras, such as LiDAR, can be passed to other vehicles within the vicinity. Moving on to V2I, or vehicle to infrastructure. Like that of V2V, this is too based upon a direct communication link, but in this case, one is a vehicle and the other is a piece of infrastructure, such as a CCTV camera mounted on a building, a smart traffic light, or perhaps an ecliptic range of sensors. As such, this type of communication could be used to provide notifications of hazards further up the road, congestion warnings, which could trigger satellite navigation systems to recalculate the route. In addition, the information could be used to harmonize the speeds between vehicles, set traffic lights to green, to give a clear route to emergency service vehicles, such as fire engines and ambulances. Furthermore, public transport networks could be included, so trams and buses could provide information in real time regarding their arrival time. Finally, by linking to CCTV cameras or motion sensors, vehicles will also be able to see around the corner. The third example of V2X is vehicle to pedestrian, or V2P. Once again, a direct communication link, but this time between a vehicle and a wearable technology such as a smartwatch or perhaps smart glasses. In this example, warnings could be provided to pedestrians at a crossing, something which may be particularly beneficial to those with impaired sight or hearing, for example. Likewise, notifications could be sent to vehicles of pedestrians walking on unlit rural roads, whilst at the same time providing either a vibration or sound to pedestrians of an approaching vehicle. The final example is that of V2N, or vehicle to network, in which communication will now pass between the vehicle and various application servers, but this time via a cellular network. As such, this could be used to enhance navigation systems by providing additional real-time information, such as congestion notifications, triggering dynamic and city-wide route planning. Software updates and remote vehicle health monitoring could all take place across this type of connection. Not to mention sending accident reports to the emergency services when a vehicle is involved in a crash. Furthermore, healthcare information from an ambulance could be streamed in real time to a hospital, assisting the medics to prepare for the incoming patient. All in all, V2X will open a wide range of use cases to make transportation networks not just more efficient, but also more environmental and safer. However, this type of communication, which is often termed critical in nature, calls upon high levels of reliability, priority, and time sensitivity, as such requires a network which can support a sophisticated quality of service, namely 4G or 5G.